Hey guys, welcome back to Persona 4 Golden, and today we're going to be challenging this game's ultimate opponent, the most difficult challenge it has to offer. And to do so, I had to beat the entire game all over again. To even attempt this boss, you must be on New Game Plus. And speaking of New Game Plus, yeah, max out every single social link. Most importantly, the Empress Arcana, which is one prerequisite of many to attempt this fight. The next of which is, you must also be on the true ending, and now that it's raining outside on March 20th, and I've just received the Orb of Sight from Igor, if you've done everything correctly and defeated every single mini-boss inside the TV world, if you enter the Velvet Room one more time, something special will happen.
Welcome to the Velvet Room. I wonder how many times it's been that we've seen each other like this. Apparently, we met for a purpose after all. Do you remember? The Velvet Room is inseparable from the heart of its invited guest. The shape of the room and its residence are selected by my master, based on the number of guests and the destiny. But my predecessor is gone from this place for a completely different reason. No one ordered her to leave. She left of her own will to accomplish her own ends. Such a thing cannot happen to the residents of the Velvet Room, so I wish to know the reasons behind it. My ultimate aim was to bring that foolish girl to her senses and return her here. To do so, I had to know why she left, and I felt that the key to understanding rested with you. But now, I'm even more confused. I can't say whether her choice, in fact, was foolish or not. All residents of the Velvet Room are destined to find themselves. It was true for her as well. Why did she suddenly give up on her quest? That was my greatest worry. But then again, maybe my premises were flawed. Maybe she found her answer, and so left this place. In which case, my role is not to blindly bring her back. What was it that she gained? And who am I? What I may receive from you will most likely show me the answer to those questions. That is why fate did not bring a guest who only talks, but one who holds unmatched power. I would like to issue a request to you, not as my master's guest, but a personal request from me to you. Would you fight a match against me? I won't force you, of course. There's no reason for you to go that far. After all, if we were to clash, I might sever your thread of destiny. But encounters always bring change to both sides. If you emerge victorious, you will surely gain something as well. Please consider the offer carefully before making your decision. Should you opt to accept my request, bring this to me where I will wait. I look forward to seeing you again.
And now that we've received Margaret's invitation, it's time to take on the super boss of Persona 4. And well, I actually have to see the true ending happen. So once again, we're going to speak to this totally normal gas station attendant and head to the TV world. And now that we're back inside the TV world, it's finally time to get ready to summon our ultimate persona. Now, to do this, you're going to need a lot of persona. We have Izanagi, Norn, Kukulin, Tizmazitzel, Legion, Okunonushi, Nadataishi, Sandman, Orthis, Mithra, Girmakala, and Kartikeya. Now you're probably wondering, why do you have all of these random persona? Well, throughout this playthrough, every single party member awakened to their ultimate persona. Except for one, our main character. And now that we're on New Game Plus, the Dodecagon spread will be unlocked. And now, we're ready. Man, I've been waiting for this for so long. Today, at long last, we will fuse Izanagi's second form, Izanagi no Okami, which is not the most powerful persona in the game, but is definitely going to make this next fight a complete joke. Now, Izanagi can inherit so many skills, since the World Arcana can inherit from anything. And, well, that's just really the beauty of it all. You could put any amount of skills onto this persona, and it is going to be just almost unstoppable. Sure, there are some unique skills you can't pass on, but oh my god. Here we go. Without a doubt, this has to be one of the most insane ways to summon a persona. God. I still remember the day I saw this for the first time. It was right after I graduated high school. It's kind of crazy, huh? Thou art I am thou. From the sea of thy soul, I come. From the very moment of my emergence, I have been a guiding light shed to illuminate thy path. I am the original god, Izanagi no Okami. The World Arcana's strongest and only persona. And, yeah, let's see. Oh. We got a pupil. That's actually kind of rare, but we probably won't be using this skill. So, Izanagi no Okami. If you level him up all the way to 99, he will have the highest base stat total of any persona in the game. But the real reason that we want him, and yeah, I don't even think, oh my gosh, he doesn't even have an entry in the compendium? It's kind of nuts. Well, I guess he doesn't have a social link, so that makes sense. But yes, he's a persona so powerful, he has his own arcana and is not even held in the compendium. But Izanagi no Okami will eventually learn all four elemental attacks and the boosts to them, but we want him for a different reason. His endurance and agility stat is just so high, he is without a doubt one of the best defensive persona in the entire game. And we're gonna make him a bit better. In between episodes, I decided to grab a variety of different skill cards, most notably the Heat Riser skill card from the Trumpeter. And with this and the, I'll experiment a bit with my build, but I'm gonna replace Angelic Grace for that. And with these passives, Izanagi no Okami is not going to die in this next fight. Unless I just like royally mess up, but yeah, he has some skills I don't really like too much, like Victory Cry, but hey, that's why skill cards are in the game. And now that we have him, it's nearly time to take on the ultimate opponent. But I actually need to go grab my other two persona I need for this boss fight, so I need to actually grind up some more yen and get to that. So, be right back once I summon my other persona. And alright guys, I am back with new persona in hand. So, I remade Izanagi, gave him Angelic Grace, it could help out, and Null Physical, two of his most important skills to have. Also, Heat Riser is pivotal to this strategy. Next up is Yoshitsune. We know all about him, but now he has Absorb of all four elements. You can bring these into this fight, and it's going to make your life a whole lot easier. Last but not least, we have Mara. Now, at the beginning of this playthrough, I did say I would use Mara at some point, and I am living up to that, but we just need him for the auto skills and Repel Physical for the beginning portion of this battle. Now that we got that, it's time to go to heaven. Man. I know I've been procrastinating on this video for a really long time, but well, it takes a while to beat this game, let me just say that. But here we go. At the very top of heaven, if you've beaten all the bosses, are on New Game Plus, and you're on the true ending, you'll battle the strongest opponent in this game, and god dang, I hope I'm ready for this.
So you've come. I spoke to my master after you left.
It seems my predecessor also requested a duel from our last guest.
Though there's no way of knowing whether the boy took her up on the offer.
I called her foolish, but it seems we are kin indeed.
Are you sure you're ready? As the one who rules over power, I will fight with the utmost deference to you. Show me what lies beyond a mere exchange of words. I am charged with the heat and tension of battle. Now we begin. Don't disappoint me.
Huh? Wasn't she your... What the... She's floating? Her power level is insane! Don't tell me you're going to fight her!
We sure are. At long last, we get to challenge the Velvet Resident, Margaret.
That's a tough one. Darkness won't work.
And come to think of it, a lot of things won't work. So this fight changes a lot depending on which version of the game you are playing on. On vanilla Persona 4, Margaret is incredibly easy. Her patterns are very easy to exploit. However, in Persona 4 Golden, they turned it up a notch. And since I'm playing on the hardest difficulty, this is going to be tough. So, first turn. This is incredibly important. We can debilitate and have all of our stats the highest they can go because of Mara's auto skills. Next up, now that we're power charged, we are going to unleash the maximum damage Hasatobe that we can do. We can only do this in one turn because if you spend all day and night buffing and debuffing Margaret, this fight is going to drag on, and there is actually a time limit. Every 50 turns that Margaret gets to act, she will be charging her strongest attack, which is a one-shot Megiddo Lay-in. You need to keep this in mind. So not only is this a straight-up boss fight, but it's also a race to see who will die first. Now, if you max out Risei's social link, you will have the opportunity to survive two mortal blows. Risei will block the oh my god, we got a crit. That's only happened one time in okay. We're just gonna use another Hasatobe, but as I was saying before, Risei will block one insta-kill. She will revive you after the second. After that, you're on your own. So unless you have a persona with enduring soul, you are screwed. Hopefully, we won't see any of that happening. Ideally, I need to do a max amount of damage every single turn, but we can only deal out so much. So it's not so much a fight of surviving her attack, since we basically have it down to a pattern. We're going to Heat Riser, Power Charge, Hasatobe. We're only going to use those three moves until a certain point. So, for the most part, this fight, some people say they ruined it. I think they streamlined it and made it way harder because, let's be real, she was kind of easy in Persona 4, but her normal Megiddo Lay-in will not do hardly any damage. Yeah, only like 374. So, this is more or less the boss fight. We're gonna do this until she reaches 50 turns. And thanks to her acting twice every turn, it's gonna happen in 25 turns instead of the normal 50. So yeah, it's a lot harder than the original, but so far we're doing fine. As long as I don't mess up my tempo and most of our Hasatobes miss, we can miss like one or two, we should be fine and not hit that hard limit. So I guess let's head back into Yoshitsune. The way I like to remember it is, just remember what persona she has out last, because that will determine what elemental affinity she is vulnerable to.
I'll tell you now, discard any concern you may have for me. You will honor me by fighting as though you mean to kill. To hold back would be nothing short of insulting.
I'm not planning on it. Oh my, okay, so far everything's looking good. Jihad coming out. Next up is the Divine Vacuum, my favorite persona skill ever made. God dang, too bad we can't learn it. So now we just need to go back into Izanagi no Okami. I just want to also mention, it doesn't have to be necessarily these personas. There's a multiple of different ways you could do this. This is just the method I find to be the most efficient and the easiest to grind for on the hardest difficulty. But yeah, you more or less get the drill by now. We're going to be repeating these turns. Oh, we dodged. That's actually kind of crazy. Until a certain point. And I'm basically just going to be spamming Hasatobe until we get to that point. So I'm not exactly sure how you guys feel about this. I will be abridging this boss fight only to save you guys a little bit of, I don't know. What's the best word to describe it? It's not the most exciting thing in the world. You've pretty much seen all of her moves at this point. So now it's just a matter of me whittling away at her giant HP bar for a long time. So yeah, Hasatobe once again. All right, good. I should be under half.
How long has it been since I've felt this invigorated? My apologies, but I'm even more eager to defeat you now.
And now that she's lost half of her HP bar, she will do the biggest jerk move in all of Persona, cast Morningstar, which doesn't really do a ton of damage since we have defense up, and then heal herself all the way. Yeah. That is a pretty jerk move. So at this point, your next couple of actions are going to really impact this fight, because you don't want her AI script to be too disjointed. On her 50th turn, she will cast the Megiddo Lay-In, and there's nothing you can do about it. However, if you have buffs up, you should be fine. And yeah, we're just sneaking in some damage. Now, since she is in the persona Andra, her like HP and physical resistance are going to, oh my gosh, that did nothing, are going to be really, really high. So we need to get her off of that persona and go back to her first, which is Siegfried. So I basically just have to get lucky and hope that we do enough damage to where she'll use the fire move and then the ice move on Loki. And then when she's back on Loki, that's when we can go back to doing normal damage with Yoshitsune. But for the time being, god dang, Mara, being very protective here of god dang, of a snake and a pun every single time. But so far, we've not seen the first Megiddo Lay-In, which means we're probably around the 30 or 40. Oh my gosh, it does nothing. All right. Yeah, since it's resisted, House of Tobe is going to do next to no damage. You really have to use that against an enemy that does not resist physical damage if you want to do the most. So, with that being said, we pretty much just got to buy our time. We're getting kind of unlucky. I've actually had crits on this stage before, just it didn't really equate to much during that recording, but I really want to beat this time. So, going into Mara and power charging is pretty much the most efficient thing we can do. Instead of doing around 300 damage every turn, we're doing 500 every two turns, which is marginally better, but yeah, pretty much Hasatobe. God, it's just so sad to see such low numbers from such a strong move, but okay, there, oh crap, no. Okay, that's not the end of the world, but still really annoying. So now she's on the Jihad and Divine Vacuum turns. We can work around this, but it's still kind of annoying, so now I have to change things up a bit. Alright, we gotta go into Izanagi no Okami. We still haven't seen the first Megiddo Lay-In. I really hope we don't see it, but think about this. It took us so many turns to just chip away at our HP bar as is. Now we have to do that again, and then again. That's why this fight can drag on the hardest difficulty, because, yeah, she's really strong. Now, the Megiddo Lay-In from Andra is not incredibly, oh my gosh, she does it again. The one from Oberon, though, will one-shot you, so there is a distinct difference. I don't know why she gave two of her personas the same exact skill, even though I do that, but it's not, shut up. Keep that in mind, and you should be fine. I did think about putting Enduring Soul on Izanagi no Okami, but it would have been way too expensive. But back to Yoshitsune. We're far from done yet. Alright, so we're back to like good damage now. We just gotta keep this up a little bit more. Now, luckily for us, we don't have to like do any damage calculations or get her exactly under half and then do a devastating attack. We just have to survive and keep using the three same moves. Now, I know what you're thinking, wow, that's, wait, is that, oh my god, no, that's it. Okay, so this is the first Megiddo Lay-In. Risei blocked it. She cannot use that skill ever again in this fight. So we gotta step it up. All right. I'm sure there are faster ways you could do this if you had a persona and like a crit accessory and a high crit move. That could also work because you'd be knocking her down and doing more physical attacks per turn, but oh man, no. Crap, her AI is disjointed. So now she's gonna use Divine Vacuum and Mind Charge. Okay, we can work around that. It's still basically the same attack, but on the turn that she uses Jihad, we're just gonna take a little bit of damage. That's okay. We can work around this. But yeah, so now when she's on Siegfried is when I need to attack. This is the point in which the fight can vary. I'm gonna guard just so when she switches to Okuninishi, that's when I can attack. And that should fix the AI loop to a degree. So we used to attack when she was using Loki. Now we're gonna do it on a different turn. And god dang, I really want to do this. I've been trying to get this fight done for so long, but today is the last day I can even attempt it. All right, so 36 damage. We were guarding, but still, that's going to not really do a ton in the grand scheme of things. All right, back to Yoshitsune. It's time to House of Tobe one more time. Come on. Big damage. We kind of need it. There we go. Oh, crap. Okay, so she's using power charge now, so that means we're at a stage in the fight where she's gonna start being serious, so unless you're aware of what she's doing, you could instantly lose this fight, because she's about to unleash her own strongest physical attack. Yeah! She has her own Yoshitsune! And if you have a persona like Yoshitsune, which reflects physical attacks, hers drains physical, so you have just healed her for around 800 damage. Keep that. That's why we needed Izanagi to have null physical, or there's no way we'd beat this boss in the time limit, but yeah, back to damage. Okay, not bad.
How marvelous! Even Elizabeth never backed me this far into a corner. Now show me! Show me what lies beyond battles!
Alright, once you hear that, you only have a little bit more to go, but we've been fighting for roughly, like, I don't know, I want to say 20 of her turns. So I'm pretty sure that next Megiddo Lay-In is coming eventually, but there's no way around it. She's going to do that, and since we're playing on, well, the toughest difficulty, our damage is simply going to be so low, we just have to keep chipping away at her, and god dang, I love Izanagi. Just the fact that he has, like, his, like, headband turn into like TV antennas, and like he stopped wearing a school uniform and now has like a business. That's just such a cool design, god dang. But we'll talk about that at another day. For right now, Margaret, you gotta go down because you're the last thing standing in my way from a lot of things. So, power charge, come on, Izanagi. And really, I recommend you just honestly have patience. I understand I'm making a video here, but if you need to, just make a checklist. Be like, okay, she did this turn, and just plan out your moves. Since we understand every skill that she has and when she will use those skills, if you use your persona correctly and give them the skill cards that they need, this fight can basically be over before it even starts. If you don't mess up, that is, which it's incredibly easy to do since, well, that's a really long fight. Wait, what? Oh my god, no, the other one. Okay, so we are going to die. Technically, but Risei's got our back, so that's really why you want to get Risei's ultimate persona, especially for this battle, but you could just use Enduring Soul as well. We're not out of the woods yet, we just need a little bit more, and Margaret will finally go down. God dang. Just die already, come on! Alright, she's on her last leg. We did so much damage, she's actually like, just, she's almost finished, this should do... Oh man, I was really hoping that would finish it. No, we need one more Hasatobe combo. And the final opponent of Persona 4 Golden will be defeated. Come on, just a little bit more! Oh my gosh. I mean, I know it is kind of like scummy to maybe use the absorb element attacks, but I don't care, man. This fight is ridiculous on Persona 4 Golden. I'm just saying, what is more or less a pretty easy game has that good old Atlas difficulty at the very end. Unless you're playing on safety mode, that is, but whatever. Hasatobe, yet again, doing no damage. God dang, I love the animation. And the sound effects. It's so cool that, like, even the creators of the game acknowledged, alright, this persona is pretty broken. Let's give it to the strongest character in the game. And minus one, whose gender is kind of on the fence a little bit. I kind of like it how all of the persona that Margaret uses are young men that are considered handsome in the family. I don't... Kind of strange. Oh, wow. We actually procced Angelic Grace. That's crazy. We could not end this fight in a better way. It's been great, Margaret. But it's over. Like as she says no there. No, Persona 4 will live on forever. No. It's done. God dang. The project that's taken me multiple years to finish. It's finally done.
While we were fighting, I recalled the fairy tale that girl told me once.
Before that girl left, she told me this.
A soul slumbers at the ends of the world, that of a young man who devoted himself to becoming a seal. That soul is risking itself to prevent mankind, who has lost the joy of living, from calling down ultimate destruction. She told me that she was going to save him from that fate. To tell the truth, I wondered what sort of nonsense she was speaking. But no, she was serious. She said if she couldn't do it alone, she would combine her powers with those who bonded with that soul to enact a miracle. Maybe all that she said was the truth. And that was her reason for leaving the Velvet Room. She must have come to realize what I now understand. You, a human, one against me, one who rules over power. You have shown me one's potential. Those who search for themselves are no one as long as the search continues. It is an emptiness, but limitless potential. It means the seeker can choose to be anything he or she wishes.
That's why she made a choice.
I had planned to bring her back by force, but I won't interfere with her anymore. Her wish seems staggering to contemplate. But fortunately, the chains of time are loose for us residents. Even if there isn't time enough in a single era and it takes her eons, she will accomplish her mission.
This boy she took such a fancy to. I'm somewhat curious as to what kind of human he must be.
Your victory was truly amazing, and I must thank you. Of all the humans I've encountered until now, you shook my soul the most. This is proof of my reverence. Please accept it. With that much power and will, you can overcome any obstacle. Should you ever run up against your limits and feel you cannot overcome your boundaries, you'd be lying to yourself. Simply recall today's victory. There's no need to worry. Even if you should lose everything, your soul will not be isolated.
And if that does happen, just as she did for the other boy, I shall do for you.
Well then, I will return to the Velvet Room and take up my original duties. Let us meet again.
And yeah, guys, that's it. That's the secret boss of Persona 4 Golden. And just to prove, yeah, I did do this on the very hard difficulty. I kind of regret doing that because it was kind of annoying, but oh well. For defeating Margaret's, in common Atlas fashion, you get an item that basically has no purpose other than just bragging rights. I don't know why they keep doing this. Maybe it's just to mess with us fans, to make us go through such crazy lengths to get this thing, and then it does nothing. But oh well, it's just kind of video game thing, I guess. And yeah, the spiral bookmark. Margaret's precious bookmark that she gave to our character. Reminds me of someone else. Anyways, thank you all so much for watching this video. I can't say it enough, but it truly means the world to me that we can share in these experiences. And well, tomorrow is the 2-year anniversary of this series, believe it or not. Yeah, it took me 2 years to finally finish it. But now, Persona 4 Golden is complete. Once again, thanks guys. You all mean the world to me. And see you next time. Bye.